We've got a market flash on AstraZeneca's COVID vaccine. Meg Terrell's got the details. Meg.
Hi, Melissa. AstraZeneca is moving lower in the after hours on a report from Stat News that the company's large phase three clinical trial of its COVID-19 vaccine has been put on a clinical hold due to a suspected serious safety reaction in one of the participants in the trial in the UK. Now, I've reached out to AstraZeneca and haven't yet heard back for confirmation, although Stat News says that a spokesperson for the company said, quote, it was a standard review process that triggered a pause to vaccination to allow review of safety data. So it's not clear exactly what this safety event was, how long this pause could potentially last, or you know, how much of an effect this will really have on the trial going forward. But it's down about 5% here. And Melissa, this is really the first snafu we've seen in an incredibly sped up vaccine development process for multiple companies. AstraZeneca, of course, is one of the front runners in the vaccine race. It just started its phase three trial in the United States as well after starting it around the world. It's behind Pfizer and Moderna, and it does have a different technology from both of those companies. But we are digging more into this. Stock down about 5% now, and we'll bring you any more news that we get about it.
All right. I did want to highlight the fact that it uses different technology, so it's not an extrapolation in terms of the failed safety measure to the other vaccine candidates.
Not necessarily, no. There is some suggestion here in the Stat News article that there is a look being made at other vaccines for any potential similar safety risks, but not clear exactly what the safety risk was. So hard to extrapolate or to know whether to extrapolate to other technologies.
Okay, Meg, thank you. Meg Terrell joining us with the developing story on AstraZeneca's vaccine candidate. We should note that Moderna shares, which took a serious tumble in today's session on a downgrade from SVB Leerink, is up in the after-hour session to the tune of about 6%. One of the reasons in that downgrade from Leerink, Guy, was that there are a lot of competitors out there on the market. And so even when it gets out there, it's going to face a lot of competition.
Yeah, and I'm sorry for the dog barking again. If you're trying to play these biotechs or big cap pharma names on the back of this vaccine, and we've cautioned people for quite some time, you don't do it, and these are reasons why. I mean, we saw that huge move in Abbott Labs, for example, on their testing news. Stock traded, I think, 114. We said pull the ripcord. Moderna's been a very difficult stock to navigate. Gilead, obviously. And I'll say again, I think whoever wins this vaccine race is yet to identify themselves. I believe that. So, you know, there's certain stocks to buy in the space. The names that we just talked about aren't some of them, though.
The other part of that downgrade, and I thought the downgrade is interesting because they actually acknowledge that there is heightened skepticism surrounding fast-tracked vaccines, which could really throw a damper in some doubt, Karen, on the impact of a vaccine on reopening the economy if skepticism is high surrounding a fast-track vaccine, which right now they're all fast-tracked.
Right. No, I think that is a big risk to the market. You know, so much of this made of like the sort of once we get to a vaccine, it's a foregone conclusion, which I actually buy into that. But we haven't seen a stumble, as Meg said, so this is interesting. I don't know how this works. What's an acceptable rate of adverse reaction? Is there on a, I don't know how much, 30,000 person trial? I don't know, but this is a significant risk to the market, a delay in the vaccine. And then, of course, as I think you're kind of getting at that, will people be afraid to take it? And therefore the effect of having fewer people vaccinated will obviously be a damper on the economy. I don't know. This is a negative for the market.
So just to connect the dots to the conversation we had with Jared Weisfeld in the A block, Dan, I mean, he was talking about a post-COVID portfolio. That post-COVID portfolio could look farther and farther out. The more stumbling blocks and the more skepticism that arises around these fast-track vaccines. So are we positioning right now? Is this sell-off that we're seeing, a rotation into potentially cyclicals, too early?
Well, not really, because they actually have shown great relative outperformance over the last few days. If you look until today, banks, industrials, some other parts of the cyclical complex. You know, I'll just say this. I mean, one of the reasons why the idea of taking a fast track politicized vaccine is not that attractive to people is that it may vaccinate you from this virus right now that's raging across this planet, but who the hell knows what the side effects are? Are you going to give that to your kids, just so they can avoid getting this virus right now, if you saw something that came through the gates in 6 months, I don't think so. So, you know, Guy mentioned this earlier in the show last Wednesday when the CDC made that suggestion that by the end of October, get ready for vaccines. They were never coming. That was the biggest pipe dream on the planet. And even if it's coming, it's just an announcement because no one's taking them this year, and not a politicized one. And people have to get that through their thick skulls because, I mean, this thing is totally turned into an absolute you-know-what show, and it doesn't make any sense. So listen, people, there's not going to be a vaccine that you are going to be taking in 2020. So whether it's about how you conduct your life, how you invest in the stock market, it doesn't matter. It's just a pipe dream. So just stop already. Jeez.
Okay, so potentially skepticism surrounding or maybe no vaccine in the next couple months, maybe the soonest by the end of the year, Tim. No stimulus package so far. Questions about valuations in the market. Does all of this combine, this potpourri, you know, whatever you want to call it, smorgasbord of items,
make you
more skeptical about the markets in general and believe that the sell-off could continue?
Look, at these levels and where liquidity is and where momentum is, I think there's a reassessment of both what valuation should be, and that's going on right now in tech land. I think the relative outperformance in industrials and call them value stocks are a function of truly some transports we're seeing better numbers, truly some commodities, resource companies. Look, the housing market isn't going anywhere. In other words, it's going to continue to go higher. I think there's a lot of feed through to other parts of the economy there. But if you're asking me, it's almost back to your Fed question. I don't think the Fed's going anywhere. And I don't think airlines need to be trading up 40 to 50% in the next 6 months because of they would be probably the most obvious beneficiary of a vaccine trade. I don't think I agree with Dan, but I don't know that the market has to follow that course. And I think we've seen that. The market got so far ahead of itself that the pullback over the last 3 days is not only justified, but thank goodness the market's showing some rationality. And I think we could see a little bit more. But to me, whenever we've been talking about the vaccine and which drug companies are the beneficiaries, ultimately, to me, it's the market that's going to be the greatest recipient. And right now, I don't think the market really can put it in its sights, and it hasn't mattered for the market. So for now, that's my stance. It stays that way.